Okay, my beloveds, we've got a clinical case, and let's go. A 29-year-old woman, gravida 2, para 1, okay, at the 30 weeks of gestation, okay, presents to the obstetric emergency unit with regular uterine contractions every 8 minutes, okay, for the past 2 hours. Mm-hmm. She reports pelvic pressure and lower back pain, get it. She has no vaginal bleeding or rupture of membranes, thanks God. On examination, her cervix is 3 centimeters dilated and 70% effaced. How they count it? Anyway, fetal heart rate is reassuring. Great. What is the most likely diagnosis? Give me option. Braxton Hicks contractions, no. Preterm labor, definitely. Placental abruption, no. Cervical insufficiency, yes. So we've got a preterm labor. Preterm labor is defined as the regular uterine contractions leading to cervical change before 37 weeks of gestation. This patient has gestational age less 37 weeks, regular contractions, and cervical dilation and effacement. So all criteria for true preterm labor are met, period. Okay, why other options are incorrect? Let's go on. Braxton Hicks contractions. Braxton Hicks contractions irregular and usually painless. Painless. Do not cause cervical dilation or effacement. Placental abruption. Okay, presents with painful vaginal bleeding, uterine tenderness, and fetal distress. And not present in this case. Cervical insufficiency, characterized by painless cervical dilation, often without contractions, typically presents in the second trimester. So what we've got as a key learning point, my beloveds? Key point. Regular contractions with cervical change before 37 weeks. It's a preterm labor, requiring what? Absolutely. Prompt obstetric management to reduce neonatal morbidity and mortality. Okay? And that's it, yes. So don't forget to follow and subscribe not only Dr. Y YouTube channel, but as well as Dr. Y Telegram channel. It's free. Stay blessed.